This is the 2020 Polo TSI's pop-up key. As you can see, it closes that way. Let's now head up and open the hood. Under the hood, you have a 1-liter turbo TSI engine, which makes up 110 kPa of power and 175 Nm of torque. So now let's close the hood and get inside the car. So here you can see your all windows are one-touch power windows, and then you can see your door handle, lock, unlock buttons, ORVM controls. Then this is the key. Let me just show you. And now on the vehicle, it is your speedometer. This is your tachometer. Both are analog. That's your digital MID in the center, which does show plenty of information. These are your light controls. This is for traction control. That's your hazard light. As you can see, this is the touchscreen, 8-inch touchscreen, which comes both with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. That is your auto AC. So this is the flat bottom leather wrap steering, which feels really premium to home. That's the on. Those are your music controls, and then those are your controls for your digital MID display. So the glove box has a light. It is decent size. You can store quite amount of stuff there, documents, liquid tissue, as shown over there. The armrest is an optional thing, an extra thing which you have to pay for. There's no space underneath. There you get some space to keep your keys or something. And this is the handbrake. So this is the proper 6-speed torque converter, which is new in this car. That is your 12-volt socket, as mentioned before. Here you have your parking, reverse, neutral, D mode, and that's the S for sport mode. So the gear knob feels premium to hold, and it's pretty nice to change as well. So this is your reverse parking camera. This is again optional, which you have to pay extra for. It is optional, so you can choose a variety of stuff there. So now let's set the rear profile of the car and check out how it looks. This is the rear profile of the car. That's the same design we've been loving of the Polo since the beginning of its launch. No such changes. That is your GT logo. That's Volkswagen logo at the center. That's the TSI logo. Let's open the boot and see how much space we've got there. So the boot is 280 liters, not so much space on offer. It's a decent size. That's a parcel tray. The seats do fold up completely. So let's head to the rear of the car and see how to be seated in the back. So that's all hard plastic. That's your door handle. That's your power window. No center armrest, sad thing. The headroom is pretty good, but the knee room is very bad. I'm 5.11. I can't sit there easily. There's no knee room at all. So only two adults can be seated here. The under thigh support is also pretty bad. Your full screw go into the seat. So you have a center huge transmission tunnel over there, so you can only make two people sit. That is your dashboard. That's the look how you get. So this is a fancy thing. This is a cup holder, which is pretty fancy, you can say.
So now I'm about to tell you how the Polo GT TSI is to drive. So it's already been 1 month since I've bought this car, and you get a flat bottom steering wheel, which is all leather, and then you have these adjustments. You have both up and down, and then front and back. So you can adjust as per your liking, and then you have these seat adjustments which go up and down as well, and then front and back as well. So Polo, even though it's a 10-year-old car, it's still a fun car to drive. It's still a small hatchback, a sports hatchback. You get two drive modes. You get the sports mode and the normal one. I was like a little bit confused while buying whether to buy a DSG gearbox or a torque converter, but I was pretty impressed by the torque converter. I couldn't get the DSG gearbox since it was sold out, but I got the torque converter. This torque converter is a combination of DSG and CVT, so it's still a fun car to drive. So the mirror views are pretty average. It's not the best in the market, but it's pretty average. And the ride quality and handling quality is probably the best on this price point I've ever driven. It's good for cities, and for long drives I would recommend just two people sitting in it, because back seats are not that comfortable for four seats, because they have scooped out bucket seats, which is pretty difficult to sit in, and these suspensions are like pretty soft compared to the earlier version, the one which had the DSG gearbox in it. So probably that's the reason why this takes a little bit longer to launch, since the suspensions are a little bit soft. So yeah, now we'll show you the launch control. Wait a minute, let me just park it on the side. So you get the traction control as well. We'll just turn it off for the launch control and put it into sports mode, and then rev the motor and then launch. The shifts are pretty harsh actually, but you won't feel it, but then it revs all the way till 6000 RPM, and the drive quality is pretty decent, and it's pretty good actually. It's not decent, it's pretty good. And you get cruise control as well. You can set it over here. You just press this button. The down knob is for the set, and the plus, the upper knob is if you press it, it accelerates on itself. You don't have to accelerate or anything. And when you leave it, you're on cruise control. So this is not a practical feature, I would say, because you wouldn't use it too much on Indian roads, because you know how the traffic is. But then it really helps if you're on a really good highway and all. The AC cools up pretty fast actually. You get the auto AC, and here you get the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto and mirror link, and you have the auto dimming rear view mirrors, RVMs, and the cabin feels really nice. And you know, Germans never compromise on their safety ratings. It has got 4-star rating, and the car feels pretty solid. Whenever you drive, whenever you go above 100 or 120, the car just sticks to the ground, and you feel that you are not driving at that such a speed. So yeah. I wouldn't recommend it to a family car. This isn't a family car. If you have big kids, then it's not a family car. This, if you have to buy this, just buy it for driving pleasure. The ride quality is pretty good. So for two people, this is the best car. If you don't have any other adults in your house,